The process of recruitment of 450 personnel is currently underway. Let's take a look.
Curve is going rapidly high, and we are seeing many patients coming to our hospitals.
While receiving an assortment of medical equipment from the National Medical Stores, the Minister of Health Permanent Secretary Diana Atwine revealed that the ministry is currently in dire need of medical personnel to attend to the escalating numbers of COVID-19 patients.
We are going to increase more staff. We actually, in the process yesterday, were working up to late in the evening. We're working out the numbers that we need for the ICU patients, because ideally, because ICU patients, in their status, they need, like, each patient needs a nurse. Ideally, that's what we are working towards, to make sure that each ICU patient has a particular nurse to take care, because they don't have attendant, they don't have, and they're in a very critical situation, so we cannot we cannot have the numbers that are less, otherwise the services will be affected.
At Mulago National Referral Hospital, the COVID-19 treatment unit, which was closed in late February and early March due to few cases and most staff members released, has now been reopened.
We had recruited, but when the pandemic went down, I think some went up because there was no much work. But we are recalling everyone we had recruited, and we are activating. We are activating, and today from here we are supposed to have a meeting in finance, because we are supposed to get some resources so that we expand the numbers.
The ministry is currently in discussions with the Ministry of Finance and Planning, among other government agencies, to avail the necessary resources for COVID-19 response activities. Meanwhile, the joint medical stores have today handed over an assortment of medical equipment to help in the diagnosis and treatment of COVID-19.
Today we are happy and privileged to donate 85 oxygen regulators to the regional referral hospitals, so that we can optimize the use of the critical care ventilators that were installed. Oxygen regulators we are donating are a specialized type, unlike the normal ones which are connected to one ventilator. These regulators can connect to three ventilators and therefore be able to support a bigger number of people.
I can assure you that these oxygen regulators are going to be used even tomorrow. Tomorrow, they are not going to go in the store to keep, no. They are going straight into the ICU, and they will enhance what we have there. Because if they have more outlet, that means you can connect three people or two people. You can connect two ventilators, so therefore, You can expand the access to the patients to oxygen.
The equipment includes ventilators, oxygen regulators, and surgical masks, among others. These will be distributed to regional referral hospitals across the country to ease the treatment of COVID-19 and other infectious diseases. This is an addition to training hospital staff in intensive care provision.
Now, the National Building Review Board has today conducted a crackdown on buildings that were not constructed with authorization from the Kampala Capital City Authority Physical Planning Desk. The operation that was carried out in the divisions of Nakawa and Makindye saw 12 people arrested and a number of buildings shut to business.
Accidents. When you don't have the professionals on site, the buildings are likely to collapse 1,000 times more.
The office